So Scratch has a lot of bugs, and some of them are really annoying. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to fix a lot of them. So let's get started. First of all, you need a Google Chrome extension called Scratch Add-ons. So before we get into the installation part, let me tell you that this extension is completely safe to install. It does not take any personal information at all. So feel free to use it. So to get Scratch Add-ons, go to scratchaddons.com and click on Install. And this will redirect you to the Chrome Web Store page. Here, click on Add and wait for it to get installed. If you're done with the installation, let's get started with the video. The number one is do not shift pasted items. Now you surely know about the copying and pasting problem in the Scratch vector editor, which is that when you copy something and then paste it, it is slightly shifted from its original position. This add-on fixes that. So after you turn this on, you will see that it is pasted on its original position. So number two, better editor comments. Now if you attach comments to blocks and clean up, you will see that your comments are messed up. This add-on fixes that. So after you turn this on, this will never happen again. Really clean, really epic. Number 3. Disable sprite wobble in sprite plane. Now if you ever drag a costume from one sprite to the another, you will surely see a scroll bar, which is completely useless. Like, really useless. This add-on fixes that. So after you turn this on, you will no longer see it. Number 4. Enhance full screen. So you might have seen a bug that occurs when you go to the Scratch full screen mode and then go to the browser's full screen mode. Yes, I'm talking about the space right here. This add-on simply fixes that by just going into the browser's full screen mode every time you click on the Scratch full screen button. You can also hide the toolbars if you want. Just turn on this setting. To come out of the full screen without the toolbar, press the escape key. Number 5. Do not automatically space overlapping scripts. So if you ever place a block over a script, you will see that the script will move away, which might disturb your arrangement of scripts. This add-on fixes that. So if you turn this on, the scripts won't move if the block is placed over them. Number 6. Scratch 3.0 blocks on forums. So if you ever go to forums, you will see Scratch 2 blocks there. This add-on fixes that and instead shows Scratch 3 blocks. Kind of an update for the forums. Number 7. HD image uploads. So if you import any image in Scratch, it is downgraded and not so high quality. This add-on adds a new button which you can use to import images in a higher quality. Take a look. Number 8. Do not automatically run duplicated blocks. So if you ever duplicate some blocks and join them to a script, you will see that the script starts running, which is really annoying. This add-on fixes that. So if you turn this on, the scripts will no longer run automatically when the duplicated blocks are joined. Number 9. Confirmations. So in Scratch, if you delete something, it's gone. And it really hurts if it is done by accident. So by turning this on, you will get a confirmation box before doing certain things. You can specifically turn on sprite deletion confirmation to get a confirmation box when you delete a sprite. And when it appears, you can click on cancel if it was an accident. Really life-saving. Number 10. SVG uploads fix. So there are some softwares that can be used to make SVG files, which are basically vector images. Sometimes with some softwares, Scratch messes up the uploaded SVG files. This add-on fixes that. So if you turn this on, you will no longer see messed up SVG files. Number 11. Block switching. So if you have used Scratch 2 for a while, you might have seen that if you use an operator's block and want to change its operator, you could just simply right-click and switch the block. Scratch 3 doesn't have this feature, but by using this add-on, you can get it. Just simply turn this on and you will see them again, just like this. Number 12. Automatically add extensions. So Scratch 2 had all the extension blocks in the categories they belong to, like camera and sensing and pen had a category. But in Scratch 3, these blocks were made extensions, which you had to add manually. This add-on automatically adds all the extensions every time you make a new project. Number 13. Colored context menus. So in Scratch 2, the right-click context menus were all colored. This was totally removed in Scratch 3. But if you want this back, just use this add-on. Turn this on and you will see the colored context menus, which look really better. Number 14. Display stage on the left side. So Scratch 2 had the stage on the left, but Scratch 3 has it on the right, which is like really inconvenient for Scratch 2 users. This add-on fixes that by just shifting the stage to the left side. Number 15. Two column category menu. So Scratch 2 had the category menus like this, a two column one. But Scratch 3 had this vertical category menu, which is just one column. If you don't like this, just turn this on and you will get the Scratch 2 styled category menu. That is pretty cool. Watch this video next to know how to make Scratch 3 look like Scratch 2. Thank you for watching.